I want to go through the steps in using the 2's complement method to do binary subtraction. We'll also do some examples of it in another video, but let's just hit those steps. So first the question is, why would we want to use the 2's complement? And there are a lot of reasons. First, at the circuit level, if I'm trying to build a circuit, it's easier to add than subtract. Okay, when I'm doing addition, I might have to carry, but I never have to borrow. Think about borrowing. You can have to borrow from many, many digits when you're subtracting, but when you're adding, you'll never have to carry one. Okay, so it's easier at a circuit level to add. As long as we're expressing our numerals using the 2's complement method, for negatives, the math works. Okay, the math will all work out. I don't have to do anything special using the 2's complement method. And finally, this employs an idea from arithmetic. Instead of subtracting, we're adding the opposite. You could also think of this as using the complements method to do the subtraction, but either way, like, the math here is well-founded. So since it's easier to do it at the circuit level, addition instead of subtraction, that's how we're gonna do it. So let's go through the steps here. Step zero, and this is, like, I kind of put this in here as a joke, but it's gonna make it so I can refer to things correctly. I want you to remember that we have minuend minus subtrahend equals difference. Okay, so the first thing's a minuend, the second thing's a subtrahend, and the third thing, or the answer, is the difference. Okay, step one, you need to make sure the values are the same length. Now, as long as you're doing this at the computing level, like, you're never gonna grab two different things. We're gonna do this with 8-bit signed integers, so they'll always be 8 bits long, but they have to be the same length. If they weren't, for some reason, then you're not using the 2's complement method for anything. You're just subtracting, presumably, numbers that'll have a positive difference, and you'll have to pad the one of them with zeros, the shorter one with zeros, to make it the same length. Step two, find the 2's complement of the subtrahend. Find the 2's complement of that second number, the number you are subtracting. Step three, add the 2's complement to the minuend. Okay, so like I was saying, addition's easier than subtraction. So if we add the 2's complement, that's gonna be easier than subtraction. Finally, if you get a 9-digit number, if you're doing 8-bit signed integers like we have been, ignore the leading one. Okay, however you're using this method, if you get a number that has more digits, a leading one in front of it, then makes it bigger than the 2 you were subtracting with, you need to get rid of that leading one. Okay, so there are the steps. Like I say, you can check out another video to see a couple of examples.